And they continue, and they come and they join our teen groups, and they come to cooking classes as adults, and they come and they work out in the fitness center.
Ed, for many years, lived with my with our mother in Florida. In August or September of 2005, my mother finally became so ill that by October we had brought her into our house along with Ed. And unfortunately, my mother passed away in late November last year, and Ed has stayed with us. One of the things that we needed to do was to find a community for Ed. So the JCC has provided a wonderful community over the years. It's very important to remember that my oldest daughter was also a counselor here, inspired to work with special needs children because she'd spent a lifetime knowing her uncle.
Yeah, my brother used it. Show me how to use it.
For Ed, it's just been a godsend and a special community.
Oh, I think the hardest part is money. It's very costly to do what the JCC is doing.
You can be sure that if you find it in your heart to donate money, you can rest assured that the money will go directly to the children.
Children with disabilities, the cost for all of them are just, it's staggering. It's not only the financial cost, it's the emotional cost of what goes on. And it's just such a special thing to not have to burden, be shouldered with it for just an extra 4 or 8 weeks or whatever you come to the JCC camp.
If heart and if passion, if the desire to do this were dollars, we would be millionaires 10 times over. The reality of it is it takes a lot of money to do it. It's not only a matter of accepting new kids into the program, we need to raise the money each year just to serve the kids we had. If it weren't for those who are already supporting this program, we would be in real trouble.
I see the battle that we've been in since the first day Camille was diagnosed with autism, and I think the JCC understands the battle. I mean, the history of the Jewish people is a battle. It's been a battle for 5,700 plus years, and every day you got to get up and keep battling, and that's what children with disabilities have to go through. Every morning I get up and I say there's no greater mitzvah than speaking out for those who can't speak for themselves. And it's really a true thing. And this standard that JCC presents me is just, hey, look, we're doing this mitzvah every day. What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing?
What are you doing? What are you doing? We need your help. Together, as a community, we can make a difference. We can continue the model for others to follow. Please, reach down deep and give whatever you can to make this mitzvah happen.
Should start. You gotta have hope. Mustn't sit around and mope. Nothing's half as bad as it may appear. Wait till next year and hope.
Kulam Beyachad.